Welcome to GC Ready Technologies. What are the key features of Selenium? Selenium, open source and portable. First, here no sequence. First key feature of Selenium, open source and portable. Selenium is an open source software. Anybody can download and use it. Use this software with free of cost. It has a license. License name is Apache 2, but free. What is the objective of that license? See, anybody can download Selenium software and use it free of cost. Anybody can download and modify the software. If you know the programming, you can modify the means you can edit the source code and use the Selenium software. Next, you can distribute that modified software to others, no problem. But selling modified software is not allowed. Means Selenium is not commercial purpose. It is open source, free to download and use, free to modify and use. Free to modify and distribute, but no commercial activity. So that is the core objective of Apache 2 license. Suppose if any interview, if you face this question, what is the license of Selenium? It is open source software, but it has a license that is Apache 2. Okay. Open source, okay. We can download and use this software with free of cost. Next, portable. What is portable? Portable means it supports various environments. If you create test cases in one environment, for example, MS Windows, that can be used in other environments also, other supported environments also, example, Linux, Mac, etc. That is portable. If you create your Selenium test cases in one environment, that can be used in other environments. Means create once and run anywhere. That is the advantage of Selenium. Portable. Next, types of testing. Types of testing. I think all of you are familiar with this one. Selenium is a is open source software for functional and regression testing. See, functional, it is for functional and regression testing. See, according to Selenium official website, selenium.dev, you can find this one, Selenium for functional testing. We have four levels of testing. Selenium supports functional testing in system testing level and acceptance testing level. It doesn't support functional testing in unit testing level and integration testing level. Functional testing in system testing level and acceptance testing level. Okay. Regression testing, it is not a separate test type like performance testing, usability testing, etc. It is change related testing. As part of functional testing, we conduct change related testing on modified builds. That's it. See, Selenium supports functional and regression testing of web applications. Web applications. According to Selenium official website, selenium.dev, it supports some sorts of performance testing like load testing and stress testing, but it is not recommended for performance testing. Why? It was designed for functional testing only. It was not designed for performance testing. That's why our Selenium is not recommended for conducting performance testing. It is only for functional testing of web applications. Next important one, multi-OS operating systems. Multi-OS support. See, Selenium supports various operating systems, popular operating environments like Microsoft Windows, Linux, and Macintosh to conduct testing. Say it supports popular operating environments. Microsoft Windows, next Unix flavor, Linux, next Macintosh, etc. Mac environment. What is the supporting of this one? Multiple OS. Suppose our AUT stands for application under test. Suppose our AUT installed on Windows environment. You can use Selenium for testing. Suppose our software application AUT installed on Linux environment. You can use Selenium for testing. Suppose our software application on Macintosh environment. You can use Selenium for testing. For example, EFT, formerly QTP, another test tool for same category, functional and regression testing. Commutator of Selenium, that EFT supports only Microsoft Windows. EFT doesn't support Linux and Mac environments. Okay. Next, multiple programming language support. Say, for writing our Selenium test cases or test scripts, official term is test case. For writing our Selenium test cases, we can use various programming languages. Not all. It supports nearly 6 programming languages to write test cases. You can use any one of those languages. And one more thing, in interviews also you can find this type of question. Suppose our web application developed in .NET technology. For that, can we use Java with Selenium? Yes, you can use Java with Selenium for testing .NET based web applications. No problem. Suppose our application developed using Java technology. For that, can we use Python with Selenium? Yes, we can use Python with Selenium for testing Java based web application. See, application development environment is different. Our testing environment is different. Okay. You can test Python with Selenium for Java based web applications. Java with Selenium for .NET based applications. No problem. Okay. Say our Selenium supports various programming languages to write test cases. You can use any one of those languages. Next, another tool in this category, functional and regression testing, EFT, formerly QTP. EFT supports VBScript, Visual Basic Scripting Edition only. That is vendor, vendor software, commercial tool. It supports VBScript language only. But our Selenium supports Java, core Java. Next, Python. Next, C#, .NET. Say, some people are saying Selenium supports .NET. Say, .NET is suite of technologies. It has nearly 30 technologies. VB.NET, C#.NET, ASP.NET, COBOL.NET, so many technologies, nearly 30 technologies, VC++.NET. Okay. But our Selenium supports only C#.NET. It doesn't support VB.NET, VC++.NET, ASP.NET, etc. Okay. Next, Ruby. Next, JavaScript. See, Java, just a minute. JavaScript. Say, Java is different and JavaScript is different. These two are not related. Java is different. Java is programming language. JavaScript is scripting language, lightweight language. Both are different. But VBScript. Lightweight version of VB is VBScript. Relation is there in between VB and VB script, but no relation between Java and JavaScript. Okay. Next, Kotlin. Kotlin. See, these six are the new. In previous documentation, you can find Perl, PHP instead of JavaScript and Kotlin. In this new version, in this new documentation, you can find these six languages. You can use any one of these languages. Most of the Selenium testers use Java for Selenium, or you can use Python for Selenium or C# for Selenium. Next, multiple browser support. Multiple browser support. Say Selenium supports various browsers to execute test cases. See, it supports all popular browsers like Google Chrome, next Mozilla Firefox, next Microsoft Internet Explorer. Nowadays Internet Explorer slowly getting outdated. Latest version of IE is Edge. Our Selenium supports IE and Edge. Separate drivers available. Browser drivers available. Next, Opera, Safari. Okay, it supports all popular browsers. Forget about Opera and Safari. In computer side, desktop side, 90%, client side, 90% market share is to these three browsers: Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Microsoft Edge are having 90% plus market share. Okay. What is the multiple browser support? Suppose you created some Selenium test cases by inspecting elements using Chrome browser. You can execute those test cases using same Chrome browser or Firefox browser or Edge browser or Opera or Safari. Say, element locators, Selenium WebDriver methods or commands, means Selenium test cases are same for any browser. Browser driver only varies from one browser environment to another. If you want to execute your Selenium test cases using Google Chrome browser, instantiate Google Chrome browser driver in your test case. Next, if you want to execute your test cases using Firefox browser, instantiate Gecko driver in your test case. Gecko, Gecko. It is the driver name for Mozilla Firefox. Chrome driver, Chrome. Next, if you want to execute your test cases using Edge browser, instantiate Edge browser driver in your test case and create Edge driver and execute. Next, if you want to execute your test case using Opera, use Opera browser driver. Safari, for Safari, use Safari browser driver. Say, conclusion, Selenium test cases are common for, Selenium test cases are same for every browser. Browser driver only varies from one browser to another. Okay. Next, sixth one, observe this point, testing variants. See, we already discussed it. Our Selenium supports functional and regression testing of web applications in system testing level and acceptance testing level. Okay, in functional testing, different variants. Selenium supports batch testing. See, batch testing is not a separate test type. It is an arrangement executing series of test cases, or group of test cases, or bunch of test cases, executing group of test cases is called batch testing. For creating test batches, no test case dependency is required for Selenium. Selenium supports test independency. Okay. Next, Selenium supports data-driven testing. Data-driven testing. It is also an arrangement. It is not a separate test type. As part of functional testing, we conduct batch testing, data-driven testing. What is data-driven testing? Testing a test case with multiple sets of test data. Testing a test case with multiple sets of test data. Suppose for one input, my test case is working fine. My application functionality is working fine. Then why I need to test a same test case? Using multiple sets of test data? For conducting positive and negative testing, we use data-driven testing. Suppose for valid inputs, my application is responding fine. My functionality is working fine. What about handling invalid inputs? For positive and negative testing, we conduct data-driven testing. As part of functional testing, Selenium supports data-driven testing. You can use Excel file or text file as resource, test data file, and conduct it. Next, cross-browser testing. Cross-browser testing means you can test browser compatibility using Selenium. Our Selenium supports various browsers for executing test cases. Database testing also. Database testing is subset of functional testing. Okay, it is also part of performance testing. Database testing is independent topic nowadays, but it is part of our functional testing also. See, our Selenium WebDriver doesn't support database testing directly. Why? Our Selenium WebDriver doesn't have any built-in features. No built-in feature for supporting database testing. Using programming, we can connect to database and test database using SQL commands. Suppose if you are using Java for Selenium, Java supports database connectivity using JDBC, Java Database Connectivity. Using programming database connectivity feature, our Selenium can connect to backend databases and conduct database testing using SQL commands. So, testing variants: batch testing, database testing, cross-browser testing, and database testing. Data-driven testing is different. Database testing is different. Okay. Next, parallel testing. Say, Selenium supports parallel testing. Using parallel testing, we can reduce the test execution time. You can save the test execution time using parallel testing. Suppose we created 300 test cases or 100 test cases. As per customer requirement, we need to execute these 100 test cases using Chrome browser, next Firefox browser, next Edge browser. If you want to execute on single machine, suppose 100 test cases are taking 1 hour, just assume 300 on Chrome browser 1 hour, Edge browser 1 hour, Firefox 1 hour, 3 hours. Instead of that, if you use Selenium grid, using 2 or 3 computers, you can distribute the load. Suppose execute 100 test cases using Chrome browser on first machine means computer, execute same 100 cases using Firefox browser on second machine, execute same test cases on third machine using Edge browser, then definitely you can save the execution time. Parallel testing, executing test cases in parallel using multiple machines. Machines means computers. You can execute using various operating systems, various browsers using multiple computers. So using parallel testing, we can save the our test execution time. These are the key features of Selenium. Thank you.